Jack of All Trades can show you just how affordable quality home repairs and maintenance can be. I work closely with local tile and painting contractors and have assembled a team of skilled carpenters, plumbers, locksmiths, and electricians who can address all your residential and commercial needs. From small repairs around the home or office, a new deck or fence, a complete remodel, or even a home addition, Jack of All Trades has you covered. Call us at 707-331-0979 or just Google Jack of All Trades in Sonoma. That number again is 707-331-0979.
Kurt Jones, licensed general contractor, number 919-520. It's The Loan Show on KSRO with George Adair. Call in with your questions now at 636-1350.
And we're back. I got the thumbs up from Michelle saying we are live. That's, I'm learning all the radio jargon stuff, trying to become an expert.
And the silence, a little hand signals that I get?
Yes.
My hand signals are very different than Mike DeWalt's hand signals, so I'll let you know.
That would just confuse me. Hey, so we just spent some time talking about home valuation. Gosh, I could go on and on and on and on and on about it. It's probably triggering some questions. It looks like we might be getting some calls. Let me tell you, we last week I launched the appraisal credit by text. If you texted the single word home loan, so no space, to 41411, home loan to 41411, we are offering free appraisals at Bay Equity Home Loans. And that's up to $450 credit. So if you send that text, it's a good way of reaching us. Another way to reach us here live in the studio, 636-1350. The next segment here, I told you we're going to talk about credit. So much involved in understanding how credit works. And there's all these very sophisticated algorithms. I can't even spell algorithm, so I can't really explain how they work, but I can explain what the end result of some of the things you do with your credit is, with regards to the three different credit repositories. And the three repositories are Experian, TransUnion, and Equifax. So I'm going to dig into that in just a moment, but it looks like I do have a call, and it's Savita. Am I saying your name right?
Yes, that's accurate. Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you for calling. What can I do for you?
Well, there's a couple questions that I have. One is, in applying for a refi loan, do they take into account income from the property itself, meaning there are two rentals on our property that are very stable rentals? Does that become a part of the picture?
It does. There's a lot of variables that I'd have to look at, but a couple of the key questions I would have is, first off, are these room rentals or are they separate rental units on your property?
They're both separate.
Okay. And they're legal?
One is a non-conforming that was there when we actually purchased the property about 4 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a unit that was built into the garage that is to code but never permitted.
Okay. That could present a problem. It depends on workmanlike manner is what we call it, workmanship of that. And also, if it's not built to code, it's an unpermitted addition. So that can be a problem with valuation, too. But with the root of your question is, can you use income from your property to qualify for a loan? As long as you've been showing that on your tax returns, you can use that to qualify in most cases. So let me ask you, have you been claiming it on your taxes?
We have not been.
Okay. So you'd want to start claiming it on your taxes in order to start using it. Of course, not claiming it on your taxes, you're exposing yourself to some potential liability there. So you want to certainly be aware of that. Any income received from rental is, according to the IRS and State Franchise Tax Board, is taxable income. So I would definitely recommend you start reporting that. I know it's kind of easy not to, especially if it's cash, but there could be some penalties there for you. But you can't use it to qualify unless you are claiming it, okay?
Gotcha.
Okay. Oh, another thing for folks, and Savita, I don't know if your other unit is this, but if one of the units is a manufactured home, that can create a problem because the manufactured home and a single family residence on one parcel can create a problem for the lender. Okay?
Okay, and why is that?
Because there are two different types of properties. A single-family residence is a stick-built on a foundation, traditional construction, and a manufactured home is a starts as personal property in a lot of cases, or it's built out, and the lenders consider them two different types of properties. In most cases, they don't make loans on manufactured homes.
Gotcha.
Okay?
Okay.
So, hey, thanks for your call. We're going to go to John in Sebastopol. John, what's your question?
Yeah, hey, George. My wife and I, we've been thinking about refinancing, but we're concerned about our credit score. I mean, it's fair to good. But our question was, what is the lowest score you kind of need to qualify for HARP?
Well, that's going to be a good segue into this segment. And thanks for the question, John. Basically, you need a 620 FICO score in order to qualify for any Fannie Mae conforming loan today. And so as long as you have a 620 and you have good income, you should be able to qualify for HARP. So, hey, John, thanks for your call. You know, basically, the features of the HARP loan require just the same as any other loan. You have to qualify with income and credit and assets. And so having a good credit score is part of HARP. Now, some lenders have their own credit overlays as well. So you may find that some lenders aren't willing to make a loan to you unless you have maybe a higher credit score, like a 640. At Bay Equity, we do the HARP loan. We do it with a 620 FICO score or higher. And we will help guide you through analyzing your credit and income to see if you can qualify. We're going to jump into another break here. And then I'm going to jump into a little bit more about credit, and I want to get into some of the nuances of credit and how it impacts your ability to obtain financing or refinance or get a purchase loan. So keep your calls coming if you want to call us here at the studio. That's 636-1350, 636-1350, and text us the word home loan at 41411. We'll be right back.
To find out more about Bay Equity Home Loans, call George Adair at 707-583-8100. That's 707-583-8100.
Hey there, Sonoma County. This is George Adair, host of the all-new Loan Show on KSRO. I'm inviting KSRO listeners to join me on Wednesday at 12:30 for a lighthearted but informative look at mortgage and real estate matters that affect you. I want your calls and questions, so join me Wednesdays at 12:30 for the Loan Show on KSRO. Folks, you know I'm always touting the benefits of a 15-year fixed loan, right? My logic is simple. Most people will save over $100,000 in interest. You could actually own your home free and clear by the time you retire. I want you to know that Bay Equity Home Loans is offering a 15-year loan at 3.25%. APR 3.39%. So call me at 583-8100 and see if you qualify for this amazingly low fixed rate loan and start paying your loan off for good. Call 583-8100 and see how much you can save. That number again is 583-8100. Don't forget to tune into The Loan Show on KSRO every Wednesday at 12:30.
Department of Corporations number 6053919 and MLS 238915, Equal Housing Lender.
Kozlowski Farms cordially invites you to visit the farm. The Family Farm store is located 1 mile south of Forestville on Gravenstein Highway 116. You'll find treats like old-fashioned jams, no sugar-added fruit spreads, berry vinegars, gourmet mustards, chipotle sauces, and salad dressings. Plus, gift baskets and boxes filled with Sonoma County-made specialties. While you're there, be sure to sit and relax overlooking the vineyard with one of Kozlowski Farms' delicious fruit pie tarts or cookies. The Kozlowski Farms Bakery has fresh baked pies daily. Order from 20 varieties of pies or try the baker's choice of the day and take it home fresh or frozen. Kozlowski Farms is happy to serve you daily from 9 to 5. Call 887-1587 for your free mail order catalog or shop online at KozlowskiFarms.com. Kozlowski Farms will ship your favorite goodies anywhere in the USA. Look for Kozlowski Farms products at your neighborhood grocery store. Kozlowski Farms, they don't claim to make the most, only the best.
It's The Loan Show on KSRO with George Adair. Call in with your questions now at 636-1350.
Okay, credit. Freaks a lot of people out. Gives them the shudders and chills. Credit is very dynamic. It changes and evolves in real time, depending on what your balances are, depending on what your lender is reporting about you, depending on your payment history, depending on what kind of credit you have. So there's a lot to cover on credit. There's a whole industry around people who repair credit. And there's some good people who do that, and then there's some sharks out there. So if you are looking to pay someone to repair your credit, listen to me here before you do that, and even give me a call. I'm a resource to people here in Sonoma County about all kinds of things related to mortgages. So if you're thinking about paying someone to repair your credit, call me first, and let's talk about it. I might be able to give you some tips. But I'm going to give you some tips right now. Credit is based off of what type of credit you have, how long you've had it, whether or not you pay it on time. There's people who have no credit, which means they have no credit scores. In this world, if you want credit, you need to have credit. So it's sort of a chicken or the egg thing. How do you get started? How do you get credit if you didn't have credit to begin with? Well, I've joked before about how the first day I went to college, there was, orientation week, and there was all these credit card stations set up. So if you turn 18, you'll probably start getting offers. A lot of colleges don't allow them to go on campus anymore. But you get credit by starting with maybe a higher interest rate credit card, and then you go from there, and you just build it and build it and build it. When you get a mortgage, that's sort of the pinnacle of credit. You've obtained the highest classification of credit. It reports the best for your credit score, in my opinion. I don't know all of this. I guess I'm going to give you a big asterisk right now. Okay, I am not a credit expert. I'm a mortgage expert, and I know how credit impacts your ability to get a loan. But I'm going to give you some tips on how to get credit score up. If you have credit balances that exceed more than 50% of the credit limit, so say you have a Visa, and it's got a $5,000 limit, and your credit balance is over $2,500, you want to bring it down to under $2,500. It's best to bring it down to under 35% of the limit. So if it was a $1,000 card, you want to bring it down to under $350. It gives you good scoring. You also want to make sure you're using your credit at least once every 90 days. If you're not using your credit at once every 90 days, it actually doesn't give you reporting. It goes into kind of a suspense status. If you have bad credit, you should dispute it. Now, there's a free resource. I'm going to post this link on our Facebook page. So come see us at facebook.com/Bay Equity Loans, and I will provide you with a link that gives you free access to your credit report. It's put out by the federal government. They're not going to try and sell you anything. And Congress passed this law a few years ago that said everyone should have right to pull their credit. So you can find that at our Facebook page. So I'd like to see you do that. You can also email me, I've given that email address out, but it's loanshow@ksro.com, loanshow@ksro.com. So some other ways to improve your credit are to make sure that you don't have too many credit cards. If you have too many open accounts, you're overly exposed, your scores will stay low. If you have only one or two accounts and something happens to those accounts, let's say you have two accounts and one of them's delinquent, that's 50% of your credit profile,
yeah.
Right? That's going to just tank your credit score. The thing about credit is time heals all. If you've had a bankruptcy, it no longer will impact your credit score after 7 years. However, all bad credit could show up on your credit for 10 years, okay? But it can't hurt you for after 7 years. Public records show up on your credit. So if you're late on your taxes, it shows as a tax lien. You want to get those addressed and get them released. It'll still show up on your credit, but get them released. So the biggest thing you should do is be aware of what's on your credit report, get it pulled, and work to repair it. You can go online to any of the three bureaus' websites, TransUnion, Experian, or Equifax, and you can dispute credit there. Also, one thing we do, Michelle, is if we have a borrower who's right on the line of getting maybe a better rate by having a higher score, or maybe they're on the line for even qualifying in general, we can do some things with them, get their credit profile run, take a look and see what their budget is to pay down some debts or even pay off some debts. And then we can do what's called a rapid rescore. And within 3 to 5 business days, they have a whole new credit report.
Wow.
As a result of some of the fixes that we help them implement. So there's a lot of tools and tricks to the trade with credit. And having a great credit score, of course, is something that's mandatory in qualifying for a mortgage. And that's why it's relevant today. I want to thank you all for joining us for The Loan Show on KSRO 1350. We're here every Wednesday at 12:30. Tell your friends and family. And if you're interested in getting a loan, give us a call at Bay Equity Home Loans. Our number is 583-8100. Have a great day, a great week. We'll talk next Wednesday.